Good evening, Richardson ISD parents. My name is Bethany Joyner, and I have your child in my math class this year. Just a little bit about me. I graduated from the University of Texas at Austin, hook 'em horns, and my degree is in mathematics. This will be my 13th year teaching. This is my 7th year here in Richardson at Berkner High School. As far as the courses that I teach, I have pre-calculus and AP calculus. And one of the things that I really love about getting to teach those courses is that it's mainly seniors, handful of juniors. But I think that the excitement and anticipation about the decisions that they're getting to make as far as what their future is gonna look like brings an energy into the classroom that I just love being a part of. Whether it's going into college, university, trade school, whether it's the workforce, I feel like all of your children just have really big decisions and exciting things ahead of them, and I love being a part of that. As far as expectations, I have one virtual class and then 5 face-to-face classes. If your student is in the virtual section, they are expected to be online during the class period start and end times. For that period, you can find the bell schedule on my website. You can also find it on the RISD Berkner High School homepage. If your student is face-to-face, they'll be showing up to class. They will be wearing masks and socially distanced, but I'm super hopeful that they'll still enjoy the learning environment, that we can be really effective in what we're doing in the classroom and, you know, just help your kid improve their math skills and prepare for whatever future they have in mathematics, whether it's just getting the credit and graduating, that's fine too. If your student is in pre-calculus, you do not have any end of the year math assessment like STAR or anything like that. But a lot of the skills that we'll be practicing will be on the ACT and the SAT, which is a big deal for a lot of kids that are applying for college. If your student is in AP calculus, we do have an exam at the end of the year for college credit. If your child passes it, they'll get one semester of university level calculus. We do sign up for that in October, which is pretty early into the year. But the hope for that is that if they sign up in October, they'll really be committed to working hard and, you know, going through that, you know, process of preparing for that college level exam. As far as tutorials, I am available Friday morning and Wednesday and Thursday after school. But by no means does this mean I'm not available at other times. I know that things are crazy. Kids are working and in sports and clubs. And so as long as they reach out and let me know that they need help, we can work something out. Whether it's a lunch session or a different day or whatever, we can work something out. I'm very accessible to your students. So they are on Remind 101. Which is a messaging service approved by the school district. They can also email me and they can comment on items on Google Classroom. So I do try to respond as quickly as possible to messages and comments that I get. And that would be the same for you. If you have any questions, I would definitely encourage you to reach out to me sooner than later. Even if it seems like a silly question, I'm here to help. As far as grades and stuff like that, we have 2 main categories, major and minor. Major would be things like tests, and then minor would be things like quizzes, reviews, homework assignments, that kind of thing. One of the biggest pieces of advice that I can give you as a parent to assist your student is to monitor focus. I'm not going to post grades on Google Classroom. I typically use that more for resources, copies of notes, things like that. But most of your child's assignments will be given through Delta Math or quizzes or other online resources. So those grades will all be funneled into Focus and what you see online. I do my best to keep that super updated. All of your teachers' contact information is on Focus, so it's a very streamlined opportunity for you to not have to look at a bunch of different things and just look at one thing. To know how your child is progressing, if they're meeting expectations, etc. The last thing that I would leave you with is just like a hopeful message that this year is going to be great. I know that things will look different, and that comes with a lot of different feelings for a lot of your kids, maybe some anxiety about whether there's going to be prom, whether there's going to be graduation, if there is, what that's going to look like. And so I would just do your best to stay positive and just remind your kid that we can still make a really great year out of 2021. So we're all in this together. I'm here to help. Please reach out to me if you have any questions or if you would like clarification on anything that I've said in this video. You are on my website, so if you want to click on the course tab that your student is enrolled in, you can find more information. So have a great evening, and I hope that you have enjoyed meeting all your children's teachers today.